Welcome back to my channel. Today we're gonna make a stuffed chicken breast. It's gonna be with ham and cheese, so let me give you the ingredients. Okay, so for our chicken breast, we're gonna use the thinly sliced chicken breast. You can already order it like that, or you can cut it yourself. If not, you're just gonna tell the butcher to butterfly it for you, or thinly slice. So you can use one slice, depending on the size, or you can use two. And then I'm gonna show you what to do with this. We're gonna pound it a little bit with a. You're gonna use a plastic bag. Okay? So you just put your breast in here and then close it, and then we're gonna pound it. So I'm gonna show you later what to do with that. And also, we're gonna need some salt, pepper, and half a cup of flour. That's gonna be for when we roll up our chicken breast. Some mozzarella or provolone. It's gonna be optional what kind of cheese you wanna use, and also what kind of ham, turkey breast, prosciutto, speck, any kind of meat that we're gonna need for the stuffed chicken breast. And also one egg, a whole egg with salt, pepper. And also I have this pan full. This is gonna be optional. I'm gonna show you two ways on how to do it. You can do it on the pan or in the deep fry, pan fry. So I'm gonna show you both ways. So I'm gonna come back and show you how to do the pounding. All right, so we're gonna need a bag or a plastic film, and then we're just gonna cut it so that way when we pound our chicken breast, you know, it's gonna be optional what kind of size you wanna use. Make sure you know it's a thin slice, because we're gonna pound it a little bit more so that way, you know, spans. So you can use your knife or the meat pounders. And also you can use your hand like this, so it's gonna be optional. Or the pin roller, same thing, you know, just gonna pound it like this all the way. So I'm gonna pound this so that way you can see it, so that way you don't hear all this noise. And then I'm gonna come back and show you how to season it and roll it. Okay, so like I said, you know, you can use the pin roller or the knife. See, if you're gonna do it with the knife, you're just gonna go like this. Going that way, okay, slowly. So that way you don't break your chicken breast, because it's gonna be very thin. As you can see, it's paper thin. So now we're gonna season it with your choice of seasoning. You can use anything, salt, pepper, rosemary, thyme, sage, salt, pepper only. It's gonna be optional. Then, like I said, you can use prosciutto, ham, turkey breast. I'm using turkey breast for this one. Same with the cheese. You can use any cheese that you like. This is a fresh mozzarella. Mozzarella. And then what we're gonna do, we're gonna roll the widest part. Okay. So this is what you're gonna do. Tighten them up like this. You're just gonna make a little roll. Let me see, like that. And we're gonna leave it like this. So I have these ones already done, so I can show you. So make sure, you know, it's always the same in the bottom. And then we're gonna do two versions, the just flour and breaded one, so that way you can use both methods. So for this one, for the just the flour and egg wash, I have one egg with the salt, pepper. Okay. And then flour, same thing, salt, pepper to taste, half a cup of flour, or as you need it. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna egg wash first for this one. Okay, just like that. And then we're just gonna flour it. One around. Make sure it's nice and tight, so that way it doesn't open when you're pan-searing it. And also for the other one, the breaded one, like this, it's gonna be a three-step. Flour, the egg wash, okay, and then the breadcrumbs. And you can use any breadcrumbs, but I prefer the panko, Chinese breadcrumbs, it's better. Okay, so we're gonna come back and show you what we're gonna do next. So Okay, so we're doing the two versions, the fancier. As you can see, I have already some of them cooking. So remember, the seam is gonna be on the bottom. Okay, and we're just gonna keep cooking it all around. As you can see, this side is still raw. Then we're just gonna go around, but you're gonna start seeing on the bottom right here how the temperature starts to change and it's getting, you know, whiter. And then you're just gonna go all around. You see the serum all around like this. So make sure it's like this golden brown. Okay. And it's gonna take about 5 minutes or so. And then the other one, the pan fry, same thing. We're gonna fry them, so it's gonna cook faster. Okay. And then we're just gonna let them cook into golden brown, like this. And then we're just gonna let them rest over here. And then we're gonna come back and I'll finish our chicken roulade. Okay, and also you're gonna sear them on the top and the bottom. It's cooked already, but we're just gonna sear them, okay? Just like that. And as you can see, this one is getting done. So we're gonna remove some of the excess of the oil and let it rest over here with the other one. Same thing with this one. So that way you don't lose all the cheese. Okay. And we're almost done, so I'm gonna come back and show you the final dish. Okay, so what I did, I just sliced my chicken breast. As you can see, they're nice and done. Same thing with the breaded one. So let me show you once again. And if you have a cheese knife or a serrated knife, red knife works better. Okay, just like that. And then you're just gonna plate it however you want. You know, it's gonna be up to you what kind of sauce, what kind of garnish you wanna use. But I have one already plated, just so you can see. I have the roasted bell pepper sauce. I have this recipe in my channel. So you go to the sauces and go into roasted bell pepper sauce and you're gonna find the sauce. Also for the gnocchi, I got the recipe for the potato gnocchi. And then you can use, you know, any sauce that you like. So hopefully you guys like my video. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Also on Facebook, Chef Alex Perez on YouTube. And enjoy. Thank you.